Welcome to Odoo Essentials. Now that you've started using Odoo, let's go through the interface. This may seem a little bit complicated at first, but it remains the same through each app, so you'll quickly become familiar with it. After the next demonstration, working with Odoo will seem like child's play. Okay, so let's go ahead and enter our database. Here I am on my main dashboard. Here I will see all of the applications that I have installed. On the top right corner, I also see a few other icons. I have this little clock icon, which will show me all of my activities, and it will show me in which each app the activities are. So today I see I have a meeting scheduled in my calendar. And I can also see here that that's in 2 hours. That's really neat because it will help me prepare and be sure that I have everything in order before 2 hours from now. I can also see my late activities and my future activities. And here I can also click directly on these buttons and it will redirect me to the activities page. I'm not going to do that right now. I'm going to go on, but we talk about it more in the activities video. So here I'm going to click on this conversations icon. Now here I can see all of my conversations. I can also see only my chats or the channels that I follow. And I can also create a new message here from clicking on that button. Super easy, super intuitive. I also have a little tool set icon here. When I click on this, it will give me the possibility to install Odoo Studio. That's an application that we're going to talk about in a future video, but if you already have Odoo Studio installed, you can use it in any application simply by clicking on this button up here. So the last icon we have up here is our personal name. So here I have Mitchell Admin, and we have a few options here as well. So if I go to documentation, this will refer me to odoo.com documentation page. I can also contact Odoo support from this page. I have a shortcuts option, my own personal preferences, my odoo.com account. This will also, once again, redirect me to odoo.com. This will be your odoo.com portal, and it will send you to the login page there. If you are already logged in, it will just send you directly to the portal. And I can also log out of my database here. Now I'm going to go ahead and select my preferences because I would like to change some of my information. So I can choose my own language, my time zone, and my email preferences. This is important if you would like to not receive emails from Odoo, but if you would like to handle everything inside of Odoo, I can just simply select that option. If I go to my language up here, I see that I have two English translations loaded. I have English US and I have English UK. Now, though it's the same language, there is a small difference, and that's the date format. In UK, the date format is day, month, year, as it is in most of Europe. And in US, the format is month, day, year. So it's a small difference, but it's important to keep that in mind. Now, if I would like to load a new language, because maybe I have some users that only speak French, I can do that in the settings application. So I'll show you that now. I'm going to go to settings, translations, load a translation, and I will choose French. I can click on load. And that way, next time I go to my preferences and either that little button that I just showed you, or in my settings, user preferences, I will have French as an option. So let's go back to our dashboard. And now I'm going to enter an application. I'll go into sales. Now the first thing I would like to point out here is that in every application, if you go to the top left corner, you will see this little icon. This will send you directly back to your dashboard. And in the same place when you're on your dashboard, you'll see a little arrow. This will direct you to the last page you were just on. So if you accidentally press this button somehow, or if you just simply need to go back to the last page, this is a super easy shortcut. So I'll click on that and boom, I'm back in my sales application. Now I would like to select some of my documents. If I go to this top box here, I can select all that are on the page. And when I do that, I have a couple of new fields here. I have the print option, which will simply allow me to print the information. And I also have some actions. Now I can export, I can delete, I can share the information, I can invoice these orders, and I can send a cart recovery email. This last one is important if you have an online shop and you're using e-commerce. Now, if I go to my search bar, I see that I already have this automatic filter, which is my quotations. Now, if I remove this, I will see all quotations rather than just my own. And I can add some other filters as well. So I have some standards here. So I can choose if I just want to see quotations or sales orders. Maybe I would like to see quotations from the last 7 days. I can do that by clicking on this. And perhaps I would also like to group it by salesperson. So here I see that only Mitchell Admin has had some sales orders in the last 7 days. So if I remove this, then I see all of the sales orders that we have. And I can also make some filters my default, my new default, or favorites. And I simply do that by going to favorites, and I can save the current search. I can say that it's my default. I can share it with other users, and I can also select a new title. So I will say everyone for this title, and I will save. In this filters option as well, you can add some custom filters. So perhaps you would like to search by abandoned carts or maybe a specific customer. You can add their name and search those documents there. Now, if you don't see this immediately, then you should go to this little search icon here and click on the plus. If you click minus, then it will go away. But I will keep it there for now. So we also have some other views. Now here we also have the Kanban view where we can see different stages, and here the stages, the columns, are actually just our salespeople. And this is particularly cool because we can drag and drop the sales orders here. So let's say that I would like that Harry Smith, my salesperson, take over this sales order. We'll simply drag it and drop it under his name, and the information will be changed that Harry will show as the salesperson here. So that's really neat. We have some other views as well. We have the calendar view, which will show us our meetings. We have the pivot view as well, which shows us some of our data. A graph view. We can also change the graphs here. And this last view is our activity view. Now, this is a new view in version 12, and this is really neat because it will show us our activities on our different documents. So here I see I have two activities that are scheduled for sales order 10, and it's the only sales order right now that has any activities. And if I would like to, I can edit the information by clicking here, and I can even schedule an activity directly from this view. So it's super convenient, super neat. Now I'm going to go back to my Kanban view. And I'm going to click on one of my sales orders. I will choose this one. Now, something I want to point out here is if I go to edit, I have some fields that are in bold, like invoice address and delivery address that you see here. Now, these are fields that are mandatory to have completed before you can save the document. So, for example, if I delete this and I click save, this will show in red and also give me an error saying that this the following field is invalid and then I need to do something here. So in order to make that go away, I'll simply add her information once again. Now click on save, and everything is the way that it should be. Now in all of our documents, we also have some smart buttons. And for example, in this case, if I click on my customer, it will send me directly to the customer page. And here I have some of her other information. So for example, I can see her sales if I'm interested, and I can go back to the sales order this way. Or I can also use what we call the breadcrumbs at the top left here. So this keeps a record of all of the steps we've been taking through the application. So I can see I started in quotations, I went to the specific sales order, I went to my contact, then I went to look at her quotations and sales once again, and then I can see every movement from there. So if I go back and click on these once again, it will send me back the way that I came. So let's say that I'm on my contact page, but I don't need to go back to her sales order. I can simply just go back to the quotations page. I can skip this, click on the first one, and I'm back. But we will go back to the sales order so that I can point out one more thing. So we're going to go here to the bottom of the page, and we're going to look at the chatter. Now the chatter will show the history of the document. It will also allow you to send emails to the followers or log notes. So if you click here and send a message, this will send an email to your customer. It may also send notifications or emails to the other followers. If I click on login note, this is just for internal communication. So your customer will not have access. They will not see what you're discussing here. So perhaps I want one of my other salespeople to help me, but I don't want my customer to know. I can tag him on the document, I can say Harry Smith. Help, please. And I can log this, and Harry will get a notification that, and only Harry will get the notification that I have sent him a message. Now I can also refer to a channel on this sales order as well by going to hashtag and whatever my channel name is. So I'm going to go to sales. I will log this. And when I click on this, it will send me to discussion. And here I can chat on the channel. So that's really neat. Now I'll go back to my dashboard. And that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.